in the high chair. My mother told me I was only less than 2 years old.
They run it into a watch. I do Thanksgiving. We used to take all the stray kids. And this kid is from Idaho.
Thank you. Welcome one, welcome all to Club Alcina. Make some noise for our amazing band for the evening, led by the sensational Yeonju Nam Kung. Take a bow, Yeonju. As for me, your MC, I'll guide you through the chaos of the evening ahead. Here's what you need to know. The club owner, Alcina, is a sorceress who has imprisoned many former party guests in her magical nightclub. She's currently obsessing over Ruggiero, who has a girlfriend named Bradamante. But Alcina put her spell over Ruggiero, so he's totally infatuated with her. Naturally, Bradamante has disguised herself in order to get into the club undetected and get Ruggiero back. She's brought along her bestie, the mystical Meliso, for backup. But Alcina's sister, Morgana, who has a loser boyfriend you'll meet later, has taken an interest in Bradamante and wants him for herself. You with me so far?
Yeah.
Don't worry, it only gets more complicated from here. After all, what's opera without a little magic, disguises, and an it's complicated relationship status? Oh, and who am I? That's a secret you'll learn when the spell is broken. Let's check in with Morgana now. Here she comes, everybody. The one and only, the hostess with the mostest, the mistress of evil, the one with the crazy outfit, Alcina.
Oh.
Whether it's love or their next adventure, young men are always looking for something on a night out. But poor Oberto here is looking for his dad, who has also been trapped in Alcina's club. There are plenty of lovers' quarrels we're all familiar with, but imagine arguing with your partner when they don't even recognize you. That's your fault, Bradamante. Try being more direct next time. Morgana's loser boyfriend, Oronte, is not too happy that she has a new crush. Bradamante has had enough of their arguing and gives them a lecture on what jealousy does to people. Oronte then has his own version of a temper tantrum. He's a typical privileged... well, you know the type. Then Morgana will do her own special magic to try and seduce Bradamante.
Il senza affanno, il senza affanno. sospiro penso ai dì.
Oh, man.
Started to feel lost, and Elchina's curse is fading off on him. Meliso gave him her magic goggles, which are supposed to let him see through the illusions Elchina has conjured in her club. Meliso then started to take an interest in Oberto, who can only think about finding his dad. And now, Bradamante has told Ruggiero who she really is, but he can't tell what's real and what isn't right now, and he thinks that Bradamante is one of Elchina's illusions. Bradamante takes this very well. Just kidding.
Thank you.
There comes a time in every club-owning magical sorceress's life when she has to face the music. Thanks to Morgana, Alcina finally realized that Ruggiero doesn't really love her and still loves Bradamante. As she is about to lament her tortured existence, she's interrupted by Oberto, who, poor thing, is still just looking for his dad. She tricks him into putting on her hallucination-inducing bracelets, and suddenly everything's coming up Oberto. Then Alcina will lament her fate, as club owners are known to do.
Oh, yeah.
Need help with that one? Well, Oronte sucks. That's about it for now. Meanwhile, Ruggiero has figured out that the bracelets are trapping him, and now he sees things for how they really are. Realizing that Ruggiero has turned against her, Alcina tries to conjure evil spirits in order to trap him there forever.
Thank you. Okay. I have a picture of both of them. They're both 81 years old. Look at the benefits of sex drugs and alcohol. Yeah, like that. A picture of both of them. Oh, man.
In this case, you
oh, this is a checking.
Thank you.
After lots of drama and a set change, Morgana and Oronte are in their on-again, off-again era. Word in the club is that Morgana's over Bradamante and wants Oronte back. Let's see where we're at a couple arias from now.
Thank you.
Her rage and magic will overcome him, or something like that. Ruggiero is terrified, but is comforted by Bradamante, who brings him an ancient, powerful sword that is supposed to help end the curse that overtakes the club. Ruggiero isn't sure about it at first, but then is overcome by the power of the sword.
Thank you. Thank you.
So Alberto is back, still no dad. He woke up from Alcina's spell, and he's calling her out, but she'll get her bouncers to drag him to the club dungeons. Poor little O. Then Alcina will try one final time to break up Bradamante and Ruggero. Let's see how that goes for her.
Barba! Barba, io ben lo so, e quello ai genitori che nel mio tuo volo ha mangiato in mano. Mangia,
oh.
take the sword and plunge it deep into the center of Alcina's club, bringing an unprecedented change to Club Alcina forever.
Thank you. I love the wife. Wow. Great audience participation.